Hi, and welcome in another episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Today, I want to show you how to create and deploy a .NET Core website to Azure from a Linux machine. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de cette vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. Hello again! Let me introduce myself. I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP, based at Montreal in Canada. In today's demo, what I want to do is create a .NET Core website using an Angular template and deploy it to Azure. We'll do all that from a Linux machine. Let's get started. Okay, so in today's demo, I will be using a Ubuntu machine version 16.04. I'm already in the folder where I want to create my application, so let's do it. So to do that, I will use the command .NET new Angular. We have multiple templates. Today I will use Angular, and I'm specifying the name of it, so it will be Frank Angu Demo. So run that. Okay, so now the app is created. Let's go in it. And now what we need to do is we need to update the npm package. So to do that, I will use the command with sudo to be sure that everything is present. Voila, everything is here. I needed to clean my screen because I had the typo in my command, but this is all of it. So now we'll edit the application to be sure that, you know, we're deploying our version. So I like to use Visual Studio Code. So now just need to do the code dot to open it in a folder mode. Just like that. Perfect. So here I have all the structure of our application. Now let's go in the application like Git, and let's go in home, and in home component, instead of hello world, let's put hello, and let's put the Angular demo. Let's put Frank Angular demo. Voila. Perfect. So now I have everything set up. So the first way I want to show you how to deploy is using a Git repository. So it's very interesting and practical if you're in a dev environment, because every time you push your modification, the application will be build and publish deploy. So to do that, I will use the compatibility with Git of Visual Studio. So just go here, and I need to init. So just initialize a repository, and that's it. So now everything is in there, so I will change everything. So and voila, and yes, put everything. Perfect, so everything is now checked in locally. So now what I need to do is go in Azure and create a web app, and get that Git repo from there and add it as a remote. I could do it in a portal, but let's use the Azure CLI functions. Okay, so let's go back in the terminal. I will clear my screen so everything is clean for you. What we need to do is create a resource group. Every deployment start with that. So Azure group create, and I'm calling mine Cloud 5 Minutes, and I'm using the location that is close to mine. Of course, use the location that is close to you. Now what we need to do is create a service plan. So to do it, we use the app service plan create, and I'm specifying my name here, and I'm putting in the same resource group that we just create. I'm using this SKU free, just to be free of charge, of course, but in a real situation, we'll use something like standard or basic. Voila, let's clear the screen to keep it up. So the next command I need to create is the web application. So let's paste that is and take a little bit more space. Okay, voila, okay. So the next command is to create the web application. So I'm creating the web application, specifying the resource group and the plan that we just created. I'm specifying also the name of my application, and one thing that is different than the usual, maybe, is I'm specifying the runtime. Here, since I'm using the template Angular, I want the runtime to be Node. You have a command. If you want to know all runtime that is available, you could do it. It's runtimes list. So let's execute that. Perfect. So now let's clean again my screen. Every time you create a web application, you have a local repository, like local in Azure, in the cloud. So now what I want to do is try to get those information. So we'll create a deployment here and I will specify the user and the password. Voila. And now I will use this command to get the URL of that Git repository and use it as a remote to my local one on my machine. Voila. So I will use this URL in this command. So git remote add Azure, that will be the name of my remote repository, and I'm adding that URL. So the next command, of course, is to do the push. So let's do this. I'm pushing to the Azure. So first it asks my password. Yeah, okay. So of course, by pushing to the remote repository, I'm triggering the build and the deployment. So that will take a little while. So I will let you have a look and we'll return just after. Okay, so it just finished. So now we should be good to check, go in the portal, check if everything is created. So this is my resource group. Let's open it. We should see. Yeah, perfect. So the app and the plan. So let's open a new tab. And let's go to the website. Fantastic. Hello, Frank Angular demo. So it worked. This worked perfectly. So every time you push your changes, then everything is built and deployed. So that worked perfectly in a dev environment. So of course, in a prod and pre-prod environment, since you want to reuse the same artifact, you could configure a CI/CD environment in, for example, a VSTS or any other system. But today I want to show you a quick way to do it without those tools. So first, let's go back in our application and via VS Code to do some little change. So here I am. So let's just change it to be sure that it's a new version. So take two, running take two, and I save. So now what I want to do is I want to package the application. So let's clear my screen here. So now I will use the command .NET publish, and I'm specifying the configuration release. I use the sudo because I want to be sure that I have all the permission that is required to package everything if I need to download or something, whatever. Well, not that long, so let's just clean the screen again. So next command I want to do is I want to create my zip file. And oh yeah, I didn't specify the method I want to show you. So it will be the zip deploy. So we package everything in a zip and we'll use the kudu interface to deploy it automatically. So right now what I want to do is go in this folder I was just creating in the bin release, and I will go in that folder and zip everything. To do that, I will use the command zip recursive with the name of my application. Of course, I need sudo command. I need the sudo permission. Perfect, everything is zipped. So let's go in this folder. So this is my app folder. So now let's go in bin and release and here and publish. And here I have my zip file. So now what we need to do is go in the kudu interface. So to go in the kudu interface, let's open back the browser. So if you notice, the URL of the kudu interface is the same as my web app, except that between the application name and the domain name, I have this SCM. So this is the interface. The way I remember it is Super Console Management, but that's not what I mean. Of course, because I was already registered in the portal, it automatically logged me in. Otherwise, it will have asked the credentials. So now I'm here. What I want to do is just drag and drop this zip file over that structure here. So drop here to zip. Now I can check it's deploying. Perfect. So deploy successful. So now if we go back to the application and refresh. Voila. Take two. So everything is done. Worked perfectly. A little bit much a little bit faster. But of course, everything was pre-built, so that's why it was fast. So voila, two ways to deploy your application. Of course, today I was using a Linux machine, but it will work perfectly on Windows, on Mac. I just want to prove it that it's functional on Linux. Of course, I will suggest to use a stronger method than drag and dropping files, but it worked. So, but if you are interested, you could use VSTS to do all those things. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. So again, this week I have two suggestions. The first one is Azure Rocks, a nice YouTube channel from my buddy Guy Barrette that is also an MVP based in Montreal. It's in English, it's really good, have a look. And the second one is another great video of Cloud in 5 minutes. Thanks for watching, see you next time.